This is a demonstration of the SmartDraft text tools. This video will demonstrate the text tools on the text adjust and text edit panels of the SD text ribbon. The commands in this video are the adjust numbers, command alias TAD. This command can be used to increase or decrease or adjust a number's value within a text, end text, SmartDraft arc text, or attributes. Select the command. At the bottom you'll see the various options. Adjust the value that you want to change. Negative would be to decrease. Positive would be to increase. So let's say we want to change everything by 2/10. A site raised in a civil engineering. The next option would be highlight, to highlight the text after we select it so that we don't get confused and say, oh, select it twice and now we've adjusted that number more than once. Precision, where you can have don't change the precision or set it to a new precision, 0 through 8. Type, this is the math function. We have add, divide, multiply, and truncate. Divide and multiply can be used with a factor to change imperial numbers to metric and metric numbers to imperial. We're using addition in this example. And if you want to use a window to select multiple pieces of text strings and text attributes at one time. Remember, this can be very dangerous because it's just going to assume that anything that you select is going to be processed. And in this case, if you had an elevation and some station values, it could adjust those station values, and maybe you don't want those station values adjusted. So using a window may be a little more chancy, but it is very powerful if you want to grab a lot of text at one time. So here, if I was to select this, you can see it's actually adjusting those text values by 2/10. And even if it has a prefix or suffix, if I select it, you can see that it adjusts it. Here we have SmartDraft text. Here's text inside of a mText. And you can see that it's not changing the precision. One very interesting thing about this command is it was originally written for civil engineers and surveyors. So text like this that is formatted in a bearing style, if we were to select the command, has all the same options, adjust by 2/10. If I select a bearing, you'll notice that it's not changing at all. It is plain just ignoring that because it knows that a bearing is a little different type of number than a standard number. But if we were to say we want to adjust by 100, the station values, here we have a number with a plus sign in between it. Again, because this command was originally written for civil engineers and surveyors, with this plus sign, it indicates that is the station value. If it is selected, you can actually see that it adjusts those numbers and keeps the formatting with that plus sign. And it adjusted those stations by 100. Very powerful tool. Next, we have the change label direction, or CLD command. This actually allows us to change the direction of text. Flips it 180. Same with the SmartDraft arc text. Same with mText. Keeps it in the exact same location, just flips it 180 degrees. If you want to use it on a AutoCAD dimension, it just changes the dimension to the other side 180 degrees. So you can actually flip some of your dimensions if you deview twisted your drawing and you need to now fix some things like dimensions. You don't have to recreate them, you can flip them using this change label direction command. The next is swapping two strings. The command alias for this is TSW. Selecting this command allows you to change the text values of text, end text, attributes, or SmartDraft arc text. So as we flipped these two, this is line one and this is line two, now line two is above line one and maybe we don't want that. So I can select line one and select line two and it just swaps them out. A quick way to do that if you're not using mText and you need to swap some lines around. The next command in this demonstration is the reposition label, command alias RPT. The main use of this command is in the smart draft labeling tool for surveyors and civil engineers. But in this text tool, it also is used to reposition the smart draft arc text and keep the center point the same so that you can move it around and keep it concentric to the arc or the radius point that was originally used to create it. You can see as it changed the curvature as it moves around, I can move it here, there. And now that set of arc text is still concentric to that original arc. The next command is a copy string. This is being able to take a source string and copy it into a destination string. Mtext, text, attribute. There are some options with this. You can adjust the number. So let's say you were working on a string of lots that each lot increased in elevation by 1/10 and you wanted to keep a prefix. Here we can actually say we're going to have multiple targets. We're going to adjust the number that we find within the source string and add a prefix back on it. Select the source. Now we just do targets, and you can see as we add it, it's not only copying it, but in this case, because there's a number, it's adjusting that number by 1/10 throughout that whole string of copies. Now we'll move to the text edit panel. The top command is the edit label, or ED command. This is a multi-purpose text editing, mtext editing, SmartDraft arc text editing command. It finds those various objects and sends them all to the same command. So in AutoCAD, you can double click on a piece of text, text edit command, double click on mtext, double click on a block, and it will ask you, what do you want to do? And in this case, you don't have to think about what it is. If it looks like a piece of text, select it, and now here we can add more SmartDraft arc text. If it's an mtext, just starts the mtext editor. If it's regular text, it starts that. And if it is a dimension, it will start the edit dimension. There are a bunch of other things that it will edit. If you're in Civil 3D and you select point number in Civil 3D, it will allow you to edit the description and elevation. Next command is the edit multiple labels. Command alias EDD allows you to edit multiple single text strings in a dialog box. So here you can see that this is multiple single text strings. I can select those with a window. You see now they appear on various lines of a dialog box. I can actually use this Windows cut and paste, copy and paste to move things between the lines. And if you have more than 7 lines, you can see you go to the next, and go through them, paging back and forth. Once you're done, hit OK, and every single line will be updated from the data that was entered into the dialog box. Next, we have Edit Text Properties. TE is the command alias. Once you select your text, and you can select multiple, you can do things like find and replace. I know AutoCAD has a find and replace, but it doesn't work in this case with the SmartDraft arc text, where this command does. Change the style. Again, the properties dialog box can be used to do this with standard text, but again with SmartDraft arc text, you'll have to use this to change any of these properties. And also it has a change case to everything uppercase. Very useful in civil engineering. That concludes the demonstration of the text tools on the text adjust and text edit commands. Thank you.